I've enlisted the help of the hunters. They comb the land in search of the lost tombs.
And what of the elusive ring?
Eluna Freya has absconded with it.
Find and kill her.
You guys know that guy?
Ravus Nox Fleuret, elder brother to Lady Luna Freya.
Awful high and mighty for an imperial rat, serving the enemy to hunt down Luna.
When next we meet, it'll be across the seas.
Kayim may serve us now as it did them then.
The hidden harbor.
Come and meet me and Kayim when you're ready.
So, how'd it go? Did you get any good shots?
Does this work for you?
Oh, not bad, not bad. You got talent, that's for sure. My readers are gonna dig this.
What readers?
Look, I'm in the print business, okay? Maybe you've heard of my company, Meteor Publishing?
Nope. Can't say I have. Not once.
Well, you have now, so don't you forget it. Here's your pay. If you get stuck for cash again, drop on by. Maybe I'll have another job for you. The name's Vive, by the way. I'll be seeing you around.
There he is, the prince himself. You look good.
You know.
Hey, sorry about the whole boat thing. I pulled some strings, but ain't nothing anyone could do after that fiasco at the Citadel.
Forget it.
Done and done. Man, I tell you, this reporter gig alone ain't enough to pay the bills. So I've been working real hard on the side.
Wow.
Yep. So, you busy?
Why?
'Cause I need your help. You fetch me some more, I trade you one of my pieces. Just like last time. Bada bing, bada boom.
That might be the oldest elevator I've ever seen.
Might still work.
Hop on and find out. Showtime.
Let's hope it's not a tragedy.
It sure ain't a comedy.
This'll do.
Still have a ways to go.
Yeah.
Bingo!
Makes the hassle worthwhile.
Dun da 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 dun da da.
Say, you buddies with the kid who's got the fancy camera?
Fancy camera? Oh, right. Yeah.
Nice. What do you say to taking a picture for me?
Of what?
A wild chocobo. Her little thing lives around these parts. But I ain't seen her for a while now. Starting to get worried.
Okay. We'll check it out.
That's mighty kind of you, friend.
Oh, there she is! I'm on it! Got the shot.
Now we can head back with the photograph.
You sure you got a proper shot?
Dude, it's me.
Take Kenny for yourself.
Dude, it's me.
Hey, buddy. How come you're all alone? You must be hungry. Hey, do you serve anything a cat might like?
That the best pickup line you've got?
What? No, there's this cat over there.
I'm only teasing. I have a feeling I know the feline you've got in mind. Let me whip something up.
You're one spoiled cat.
Aww. I think he likes you.
I guess.
Clawed his way into a heart.
Might keep on clinging. Forever.
You made it back. You guys hold up all right out there?
More or less.
Excellent. Come on, you ought to be proud of yourself, Your Highness. The work you did today could save lives.
How's that?
You see, most folks know better than to go out at night. But some people don't have a choice. Am I right?
I guess.
They may not have a choice, but my pieces can give them a chance. So hey, how's about you give it a try and see for yourself? I'm a man of my word. So here you go. I look forward to doing business with you again sometime, gentlemen.
Oh, come on!
They, knocked? I have a favor to ask.
I want to do something for Iris, and I need your help.
What's this now?
Well, my sis puts on a brave face, but I know it's not easy for her. I just wanted to do something for her to show that I care. And that's where you come in. I hope.
Sure thing. What do you need me to do?
Pick a flower.
A flower?
A particular flower that only blooms at dawn, indigenous to these parts. Iris has always had a soft spot for him.
Early morning. Well, at least it'll be easy pickings. You can count on me. Yeah, we got it.
Great work, Noct. Couldn't have done it without you.
Not really sure you needed me.
Well, I'd like you to give her the flower. That'll mean even more to her.
Huh? Why? What's wrong with it being from us?
How clueless can you be? Look, just hand it to her for me, okay?
Huh. Weird building, eh, guys? Going down, down!
Here!
That's game.
We need to replenish our supply of curatives.
Gotcha. Hey, Iris.
Oh, hey, Noct. What's up?
You know, nothing.
Noct has a little something he wants to give you.
Wait, what? I do?
Something from Noct? For me?
What? Here.
It's beautiful! Oh, I love it, Noct. You're so sweet.
I'd say you made her day, buddy.
Yeah. All's well that ends well, I guess.
Thank you.
up.
Morning.
Prince Noctis, even the Marshal came to say goodbye. I heard the Regalia's going on the boat with you. You didn't forget to pack anything, did you?
I guess it's goodbye for now. The Regalia's already waiting below deck. Hopefully, she'll serve you as well across the ocean as she did here.
Something I gotta get off my chest.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
I do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide what's going on from them. It hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards. They're your brothers. Trust in them, always.
What's up?
Please, come back soon! We need our king!
Yeah, count on it.
The wedding day arrives, but alas, without the bride. Of course, we've come for the Hydrian, and you've gone to such lengths to prepare.
Merely my duty.
Ah, but for an outsider to lead the Imperial Army must be a battle in and of itself. You've spoken to Lady Luna Freya.
No,
that obstinate secretary, standing in the way, while you rush off to slay the Hydrian for your poor sister's sake. I know the price of the Covenant.
You know, I've always wanted to go sailing like this.
Not many opportunities living in insomnia.
Out here, it's just us and the horizon. It's amazing. It's life-changing.
We've quite a ways to go until we reach Altisha, so keep gushing to your heart's content.
When we step off the boat, we'll be in a foreign country.
The anticipation alone is a foreign sensation.
And to think this is where we were headed to begin with.
We've been through a lot, and there's still more to come.
Man, is this view something else or what? I say we grab a photo. Look at you getting all pumped. I am so proud.
Just imagine all the fish out here.
Enough to keep you busy for hours. Ready or not? Oh! Love the lighting! Knocked!
Hold on. Get us out of here, Iggy.
Right.
Hang in there. Who are you?
Knocked. How are you feeling?
Did you remember to put on sunscreen, Knocked?
Yes, Ignis.
So next on the docket is Leviathan.
What sort of deity are we dealing with?
A serpent said to embody the roar and rage of the sea.
We'll have to see for ourselves.
Can't let Lady Luna Freya do all the heavy lifting. You must be so psyched to see her.
Luna?
Yeah.
Well, we need to make sure she's all right before anything else.
Indeed. Her well-being is top priority.
Don't like this going down on Imperial turf.
You think Lady Luna Freya's in danger there?
The Empire did invade Lucis for the Ring. I have no faith their ruthless ambitions will stop short of harming the Oracle.
Without the Ring, the Crystal's no more than a rock.
I suppose. Does anyone know how Lady Luna Freya came to have the Ring?
It seems likely His Majesty entrusted it to her safekeeping back at the Crown City.
So she's held onto it this whole time, all the way to Altisha.
The Ring is important, and so is Leviathan. But Luna comes first.
You know, I was thinking back to our encounter with Ravus. Do you recall an apparatus in place of his arm?
Yeah, I remember.
Seems he lost his old one in the invasion, but in its place, he seems to have acquired new power.
Power?
That would help explain how a son of Tenebrae suddenly came to command Niflheim's army.
Now that you mention it, his strength did seem sort of supernatural. I just chalked it up to the Oracle lineage.
His ancestry may be part of it, but that alone wouldn't account for his freakish strength.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
There's a disturbing rumor about. Lord Ravus has taken to brandishing His Majesty's sword.
My dad's.
Then what's the big idea behind that?
That his power's the same as the power of kings?
I cannot say for sure, but I have my doubts. Ravus wears the sword, yet doesn't wield it.
For all his newfound powers, he's still the Chancellor's lapdog, holding on to the enemy king's sword like some badge of honor.
It might help if we knew what he was after.
Who can say?
What are the odds the Empire will crash the pool party with Leviathan?
Consider it a guarantee. They felled a god to prevent Noct from receiving his blessing. They'll do so again.
But we beat him to the big guy, thanks to our friendly guide.
Never know which way that one's gonna move next.
The Chancellor has an agenda all his own.
Sometimes it helps, like when he called off his army and let us escape.
But he was still a creep about it.
who feels like he's only helping us because he wants something. I just don't know what.
Reckon we'll see him again?
Certainly hope not.
Not your type?
No love lost for phonies.
As Gladio said, his actions are motivated not by altruism, but by self-interest. And when he does come to our aid, I see only condescension in his eyes.
Yeah, can't argue with that.
Ever think you think too much?
Sometimes, but it's always preferable to the alternative.
So, soon you'll have your old man's ring back.
Yeah, when we arrive in Altitia.
Good thing. To him, it was his heritage.
Is that what my dad said?
Carrying a royal line ain't a task to be taken lightly. For a small thing, that ring can sure weigh heavy. After he became king, I only ever saw his face in the paper.
Wait, weren't you at the coronation?
No, I was long gone from the city.
Must have been invited, at least.
Had a falling out of sorts with your old man. Right at the end of the trip.
You did?
I was given to understand you stayed in touch.
We buried the hatchet years later, but never talked face to face again. Should have paid a visit while I had the chance. Well, no use dwelling on it now. Got the regalia in the hold, but y'all gonna stay in Altitia for a good while, right?
Yes, we believe so.
In that case, I'll tune her up for y'all. Not that I'll have much to do, though. Well, with Cindy looking after the old girl.
If you say she's good, she must be great.
She was never afraid of hard work. Heaven knows she had a hard childhood.
Hard childhood?
He means her parents.
Lost them both when she was little. Was big enough to understand, though. And to hurt. But you wouldn't guess that, seeing her now.
Not at all. She's always so cheerful.
Well, that ought to tell you how far she's come.
Now you must have seen your fair share of Altitia by now.
Yeah. Only done been the once. Stayed a good while, though.
What's it like?
Big old city.
Big. Okay.
Well, it ain't the crown city.
Different. Got it.
You'll see for yourself. Foreign lands seldom lend themselves to trite explanations.
Change of scenery ought to do you good.
Well, I'm all talked out. Can't be far to Altitia now, right?
We'll be there in no time. Nice having the wind at our backs.
Lodgings are our first order of business.
All work and no play?
Makes Ignis a dull boy.
Someone has to babysit you too.
You're welcome to sleep in the wild.
Ain't no hotel, but I know a fella has a place.
Hey now.
Wescombe ran with Reggie and me way back when.
Oh, was he the other one in that photo with the garage?
Yep. Runs himself a diner or a cafe or something. Go and see for yourselves.
Sure.
Does the place have a name?
McGee or Magoo or Mago. That's the one.
Nice.
You can count on old Wes, but he'll chew your ears off.
The government issued a statement promising that the reasons behind awakening the Hydrian would be clarified in the ceremonial address.
Got a signal!
Delivering the address will be Lady Luna Freya, who was previously reported dead. This will mark her first public appearance since the violence that befell the signing ceremony.
Lady Luna Freya's gonna give a speech?
Sounds like it.
Lord knows. This world could use some wisdom.
Won't be much longer now, Noct.
Yeah.
Does this vessel have an entry permit?
Entry permit?
Relax. I got one. Here.
That's as old as they get. Seems in order. You may pass.
prepared in advance.
Could say that. 30-odd years ago.
That's what the guy meant by old.
Lucky us, huh?
That could have ended badly.
Finally back on land.
Barely. They call it the Walls of Water. But it ain't just the walls. It's the whole damn city.
Which is why we can't traverse the town by conventional means. We'll need to rely on gondolas instead.
Yay! More boats.
Hey, not this. Catch. Key to the boat. What? Don't you want to go sailing again?
Are you sure?
Why not? Old girl ought to be sturdy enough. Not even an awful driver like Reggie could sink her. A king can't rule with wisdom alone. He needs perspective. So get out there and see the world, you hear?
What's next? Immigration?
What do you mean? There's still more?
Sir, what is the purpose of your visit?
Purpose? Ignis, a little help?
Utterly hopeless. We are scholars of the culinary arts, and we've come to study the renowned cuisine of your fair nation.
Is that so? I wish you an enlightening stay.
Another one you owe me.
You want to check Westcombe's place out?
Yeah, let's all go to Mago.
Perhaps we'll even make it in time for tea.
And we'd better start looking now.
Let's grab a bite.
It's a photographer's dream.
What a city.
They're extending the exhibit for Lady Lunafreya's wedding dress. The Vivian Westwood? But wasn't that a memorial for her passing? Well, now it's a memorial for her safe return. Let's go see it while we still can.
Oh, could that be the dress we read about in the papers?
Doubtless. The designer's name is the same.
Want to check it out?
That depends on the groom. Might still be a sore spot. What with his wedding getting called off?
Who says we can't call it back on? It can still happen.
True enough. Let's keep an eye out for it.
I heard there's a solid photo spot nearby. Mind if we check it out?
You know, we did struggle a bit without you.
Oh, yeah?
Couldn't get the fire going.
You could have just cast a spell.
Kinda overkill, don't you think?
Hopeless. Next time I'll show you hacks how it's done.
Ready or not?
This way to the dress?
Yep. Same street as the estate.
Seems we're on the right track.
Oh, the dress is so beautiful. I want mine to be like that.
And it shall be, my love, as surely as I am your Prince Noctis.
Looks like the prince has a following as well.
And that's the dress. My word.
Everyone looks so happy. And it's all because of this one dress.
Yeah.
Real glad for you that Lady Lunafreya is safe and sound.
Yeah.
Well, that settles it. You gotta make it happen. Become a symbol of the peace. After we tie up all the loose ends, let's think about the ceremony.
A fine idea.
Yeah, I'll think about it.
Fantastic. Call when you need a ride back.
Welcome to Accordo, lads. Sid mentioned you'd be dropping in. Wuscom Armagh, as you've gathered. My word, you've grown, little prince. But of course. You were only a babe at the time. So this is your maiden visit. Enjoying it so far? You doubtless have many questions, so ask away.
This country is a part of the Empire, isn't it?
Oh, you're wary. I understand. But there's no need to jump at every shadow. Just be aware that the terms of our independence grant the Empire free rein to come and go as they please.
We'll bear that in mind.
It's admittedly a one-sided arrangement. Most everything we do requires Niflheim's permission. And they wouldn't knowingly permit the Oracle to appear before the public. How our government spun that is quite a mystery.
You really think Luna will make an address?
If every recent radio broadcast is to be trusted, absolutely.
Where is Lady Luna Freya?
In the city somewhere. But no one has caught so much as a glimpse of her. The media has been conspicuous in its silence on the matter, which speaks volumes of government intervention. That certainly explained the rumors of disgruntled Imperial officers leaving the city.
Has anything changed with Leviathan?
For now, it's business as usual at port. But word is the government will soon open the altar of the Tide Mother.
In preparation for the rite.
But on the other hand, they're scrambling to stockpile emergency provisions. This begs the question. If they're anticipating that the Hydrian will wreak havoc, why would they allow the rite to proceed?
Do you see lots of Nifs around here?
We do, sometimes even at my place. Theirs is a familiar presence, and the citizens don't think much of it. Though the High Commander did cause a stir when he showed up the other day.
Ravus.
So soon after they felled the Archean and Lucis, his arrival fuels rumors that they will next come to Altisha. The Empire's not content ruling all the land. They want the heavens as well. Well, if you need anything else, you know where to find me.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
My dear Camellia, it's been a while.
I heard about your distinguished guests.
You've an ear for gossip.
Gentlemen, I won't waste your time. My name is Camellia Clostra.
First Secretary of the Accordo Protectorate.
You should know, we have Lady Luna Freya in our care. And the Empire demands we surrender her.
What?
Yet I am loath to acquiesce unless we stand to profit. Hence I've come to discuss terms with the King of Lucis. If you've a mind to talk, come to my estate.
She can be oblique at the best of times, but I assure you, her heart is in the right place.
Oh, okay.
At any rate, you must be weary from your journey. Might I suggest you seek your beds for now and ponder matters anew in the morning?
Yeah, I think we'll do just that.
Thank you.
He just stood there, staring at the church and looking all sad. Can you blame him? His sister was supposed to get married there. But he knew what was going to happen that day. He could have at least warned her. Well, what if he wanted to but couldn't? He must be eating him up inside.
Thank you for coming.
No sweat. First things first. Thanks for coming to greet us in person.
It's the least I could do for a king. Westcombe didn't extend me an invitation, so I decided to extend my own. Though circumstances have changed, both the king and the oracle are finally in Altisha.
You said that you have Luna in your care. Doesn't that pose a risk to your nation?
Is the king concerned for our relations with the Empire? But it's true. The Oracle is a risk, one we are prepared to shed with. Whether we do so depends on you. Now, let me ask some questions of my own. Why does the Oracle seek to awaken the Hydrian?
She wants to forge a covenant so I can receive Leviathan's blessing.
The answer I wanted to hear. And yet, king or not, it can't be a simple affair for you to receive a god's blessing. Let me be frank. The potential chaos worries me. You know better than most what took place in Lucis with Archean. Tell me, what happened?
I met Titan, and he gave me his power.
Just like the legends, though the Empire doesn't like the way the story goes. Even as we speak, they mobilize their forces. It seems there's no avoiding chaos. It will most likely come to war. However, I don't care to host a battle on my soil. The gods and the Empire be damned.
I don't suppose you'd cry over the Empire's losses?
An intriguing suggestion.
Seems to me you want a proxy to fight the Empire.
Very sharp, Your Majesty. But before we go into that, there is one matter I'd like to settle. Without further ado, let us talk terms. If you wish to hold the right, you must ensure my citizens' safety and aid in their evacuation.
That's fine, but what about damage to the city?
Your concern is appreciated, but I am prepared to accept some structural damage. Keeping the citizens safe is my chief concern, and therefore yours. And that is not all. Once the rite has begun, I will not be accountable for what follows. You are on your own.
Not a problem. We know how to take care of ourselves.
Thank you. I'm sorry we cannot do more, but as I'm sure you are aware, few armies can stand against the might of the Imperial fleet. That is all for the terms. To review, you are to ensure our citizens' safety and engage the Empire. Do we have an agreement?
All right. Let's fight together as allies.
Allies? Such a vote of confidence. Well, you can trust us to do our part and keep the Oracle safe. A final warning, though I doubt it'll come to it. My duty is to my citizens. Should any harm befall them, there will be a reckoning. For both King and Oracle.
All right. You do what you must for your people.
You're just like your father.
Thanks.
You've made the right decision.
Madam, it's time.
Assign three of your own for the evacuation effort. Whom you choose is up to you. According to our intel, the Imperial fleet will be four warships strong. Steel yourselves for a full-scale battle. I'm glad we could talk. We can each act in our own interest to our mutual benefit. I can't promise something I can't help.
Of course. You certainly opened up to them, though.
What can I say? I have a soft spot for the young and tragic. They've lost Regis. They've lost the crystal. Was it so long ago the last oracle was taken from them? We've seen the Empire go mad these 10-odd years.
During the rite, we must see to it the Empire does not harass
Leviathan.
Gonna be tough to pull off before the king receives her power.
And with three of us on evacuation detail.
Indeed. The best we can realistically do is to help the Hydrian help herself.
What kind of help you talking about?
Just like Titan, the Empire will seek to immobilize Leviathan.
Oh, with the harpoon things?
If we can dislodge them from the goddess, she will have a fighting chance.
Sounds good in theory, but don't push it. It's pointless, unless you can get that blessing.
Stay flexible, stay alert.
All right, will do.
If worse comes to worse, you can threaten to throw the trident into the sea. Then they'll listen. In the meantime, it will be well guarded. Better than the Oracle herself.
Understood. I shall reclaim it at the altar.
Remember, you'll be under Imperial watch.
Right.
Think of it as a necessary evil in order to forge the Covenant.
I am in your debt.
Once it's over, you may go as you please. But you do so without our protection.
So be it.
You'd better get going. Your public is waiting for you.
You guys too.
Of course.
Talk about a crowd. The whole city's come to watch.
Dear friends, I stand before you today with little hope the words I speak shall reach beyond these walls. For slowly but surely, the light fades from our world, and as it does, the shadows shall loom ever longer until all succumbs to the darkness. Darkness that evokes terror, hatred and sorrow in the hearts of men. The ashes of Lucis. A dream of peace twisted into a nightmare of death and destruction, claiming innumerable lives and leaving myriad souls to suffer.
Luna.
Yet I beg you, do not surrender to despair. Have faith, for our gods watch over us. By their blessings, by the stars that light the heavens above, our world will be delivered from the perils of the dark. I stand before you here in Altisha to call upon Leviathan, Goddess of the Seas, Spirit of the Deep. By the sacred rite, I will commune with the Hydrian. But first, I offer you my solemn vow. On my honor as Oracle, I will not rest until the darkness is banished from our world and the light is restored. Bless you all.
The Empire's here.
I can see him.
Dropships are closing in on the port. Look for a vantage point to approach them.
Okay, look after the citizens.
We got him covered.
So, it begins.
It is I, Luna Freya, blood of the Oracle. Goddess of the seas, I beseech you, enter into this covenant that the king might reclaim the stone.
Don't let go!
Heads up!
Hey! Your power! Give it up!
Now, about that ring. On second thought, you let him have it. And do remind him about the crystal.
Oh, Prince, your bride awaits!
I will pass the ring to the rightful king. When the prophecy is fulfilled, all enthralled to darkness shall know peace.
First.
stars of life and light.